Okay. Okay. Okay.
We could go if we had some money. This sucks. Look under her butt.
One of you boys 18 or older?
No.
Okay.
I'm too high.
Have you been screened in the last 12 months for diseases?
I'm too high. I'm like okay, but like I need some peace and quiet while I'm talking to you. Holy fuck. Ugh. I know. We'll go back to it. I'm just a little high right now, okay? I know, I'm not gonna let the fear win. I'm not. But I'm having, like, realizations about, like, you know, I'm going to sleep on this 24/7 show and, like, Weasel's picking up the slack and just creating things in the world, just creating, being a creator. It's powerful. And so when people say I'm not doing anything, it's like, you're wrong as fuck, actually, and this is a really good use of my time. And so when people say they worry about my lifestyle, it's just like, I don't know, just support me a bit more. That's all. And by the way, of course, everything else with my politics, maybe you know a little bit from listening to me and following me, but honestly, if you follow me on Twitter, I've been trying to open up, you know? I try to open up, but... Oh, wow. Yeah, I repeat the same phrase because I'm trying to reshape the way I said it or something. See, like, get a little confidence going because I can hear how raw I am in these moments, what I'm feeling. But that's okay. It's just, it's sometimes a little bit uncontrolled. And when it's a bit uncontrolled, it's like, well, you know, there's so many ways that people can parse anything that I do. So it's like, the whole world defines me and it crushes me instead of me being free. So I want to just fucking, I don't even know what I just said, but I think it was profound. I think I was saying something profound. Too weird to live, too rare to die. Explain that, what it means to you. Or rather, the context of it within the greater experience of the chat and my life and the things that I'm talking about. How do the words too weird to live, too rare to die fit in your mind? How is that message triggered by your brain? Reveal yourself. God's own prototype. God's own prototype. Is that me? You can't explain. That's okay. We'll find out together. In the end. In the end, we'll see what happens. Ineffable. Too great or extreme to be expressed or described in words. But, you know, language serves a purpose, so why don't we try? I know what you mean, though. I think I do. my servant of God. What God? Which God is that? Which God is that? Autobiography of a Brown Buffalo. Sounds interesting. You feel like we've been down this path of high before. I just got weird deja vu. Yes, we have been down here before. We have. We try to go down here sometimes. Sometimes we try to go here. And it's been like, you know, I've not been like this since I started this 24-hour streaming thing. But finally, just now, I'm hitting, like, that real high where it's, like, life itself coursing through me. And I try to explain it to people, but they think it's just, like, they think it's not something real. They think it's not, like, meaningful. I think you're doing the same thing as I was saying. I see. It's like I want to tap into the spiritual. I want to. I'm not wearing makeup today except I'm not wearing anything on my skin. Lately, I've been not wearing any makeup on my skin. In the last few days, I've decided to only do a little bit on my eyes, and that's it. Just to see, like, I think my skin has not been looking super great lately. I think, maybe I'm irresponsible with my makeup and also washing my pillowcase, which I just washed it, and often when I put makeup on, I tend to take it off the next morning and not before going to sleep. So yeah, I'm just not sure. I feel like I'm just using this product on my skin a lot, and I'm also not as diligent as I need to be with washing pillowcases. So I think my skin is not very excellent, but it looks okay. Actually, it looks fine now. I don't know. I'm just like, I've been quite peculiar about the lighting on my face. Like, very peculiar, like, very, I want to, like, control it. And now I've settled down into, like, this no makeup, blue filter. And people think my room's really dark, and it's not super bright, it's kind of dark, but I don't need that much light, you know? And I don't need to strain my eyes. I don't know. but it's also not as dark as it looks. Yeah, Panda, kind of. Except it's just like there's a lot of things to think about, right? Like Weasel doing a show on my stream. Something feels kind of magical about having a platform and then having it 24/7. And I don't see why I shouldn't do it. I think maybe... Okay, look. I think... Well, do you think I can get away with this? Because I pay for this internet. I do. But also, like, I want to record my streams, and I don't want to only... I want to record all of it. Every minute. Recorded. This is important to me. What's the solution? The copyright hell on YouTube is disgusting, and there's pretty much only YouTube and Google as, like... Or, sorry, only YouTube and Twitch are the only two places with tech giant scale resources or whatever, right? I mean, what I have to do, buy a ton of external hard drives and just, like... save all the external hard drives carefully, and you know, like, what do? Can I trust Google? Or, like, you know, what happens to my data in the end as I die? Like, what happens to my Google Photos, which I would love to, like, not be locked away forever? And I want my data to be used to create me. But the problem is, if I give my data to some big company, then they kind of have control over it. So, I don't know what the solution is. I'm fine with every minute being like, Maybe the archive could be available to, I don't know, subscribers or something. Is that a way to make this sustainable? But what is the archive? I need like a new service, pretty much. One that won't... Basically, I need a service that's like... Ideally, not just one service. Ideally, multiple services. But, like, what happens to my data? It's public. My data is public, so other people can, like, create their own shadow version of me. They can borrow me and transform me. Here's what I need. I need a small apartment, which I already have. Okay, I have a small apartment. That's one thing that I have. I have this PC, which is kind of old. I have this table. I have headsets and microphones and capture cards and monitors and a couple lights. And I have, monthly HRT prescription and Lexapro prescription, and I have Soylent shipments, and I have like unlimited internet, supposedly unlimited, and I have like a mirror and a bed. I have an AC, and I have a microwave. I have a refrigerator, I have a bathroom, a bathtub, and I just basically need those things. And also electrolysis. It's like every 2 weeks. And sometimes THC, I don't know if there's bad long-term effects of it, but it seems to do interesting things to me and my mind, which seems to be kind of beneficial for what I'm trying to do. Even though I don't have much self-confidence, what I'm trying to... this is pathetic video 3, basically. This is pathetic video 3 right now. Oh my god, what if I learned how to, like, make highlights as I'm streaming? I just open Premiere and, like, dump... See, I think I need some... You see what I need? I need a room to live in and some basic life shit. And I need internet unlimited. I need, like, infinite data storage that's not gonna get fucked by copyright algorithms. And I just need a place to put all that shit. I need the ability to stream. I need, like, healthcare and the apartment to do it in. And I just want to do it. And then I have the platform to build myself. And then that's what I'm doing. I'm okay, Panda. I mean, I dealt with a lot of people's shit. Like, I'm okay. I just don't feel like... And I'm not alone, by the way. I'm not alone. There's other people. Not necessarily a 24-hour stream thing. Not necessarily anything like that. But, like, there's a lot of people out there who have, like, miscellaneous creative... in, like, impulses, and they want to, like, just create, they want to create things, or they want to, like, put something together, and they're just, like, wired in, and, like, all the other bullshit in life, it gets in the way of that, and it's, like, all that other bullshit needs to, like, disappear, it needs to disappear, and then... We're just in the zone, and we're doing it, and we're living it. But sometimes we don't want to create, we just want to absorb. Sometimes we just want to, like, take in. We want to just experience. We want to relax and experience other things that interest us. We want to intake. And that's fine. That's fine to do. And, like, a lot of people do that. Tons of people do that. It's just some people don't output like we do, I guess. Like, I don't know who I'm really speaking with. Just, like, there are people wired in, and, like, I consider myself to be wired in. I'm wired in. And so, You're just a neat. Does that mean, what do you do? Do you just, what do you do with your spare time? this print screen not always work? Drives me mad.
Come on over here.
Come on, coward.
Coward! I know that I want to punch you in the nose. I'll beat your goddamn ass, you son of a bitch.
You're an intellectual dumbass.
And I'm coming. You coward. You think you're a tough guy. I hate you, coward. We're going to defeat this anti-human scum. We're going to...